Oh, you bypassed me that time. That makes everyone sad.
Hi, everybody.
Hey, we're streaming stuff.
It's stream time.
Hey. Oh, let's see. What is this? Is that? I can't tell. It's some sort of JRPG.
How are you all tonight?
That's a good question. It's a question that I would like an answer to.
We're happy to be here.
John, what game is this? Oh, it's Rise Strike Event? No, that's probably a motto.
Blade and Soul.
It's Blade and Soul. It's Blade and Soul. I can play for free now. That's cool.
It's Blade and Soul.
Nice gift, by the way. Yep.
So here's what we got gift-wise, so you can keep your eye on the windows.
Okay, give me just a second here. I'm starting up Alpha Geek. No, don't, no, no, no. Okay, ready.
Okay, the scary one. Bah! It'll happen in a minute, and then it'll be scary. Bah!
Okay.
Bah! Ah! There it is.
It's the duck thing, ducky.
And then this one. This one will probably go for most of it.
It's so dumb and I love it. Oh, there goes our Twitch stream.
Where?
Apparently they don't like it when puppies get hurt and
no
wasted.
Oh, puppies.
No puppies.
So yeah, just every now and then I'll just get to mess with people. Bah!
She's like, oh, duck.
Yeah, make him slightly afraid to ever look and see what's going on with the dog. If I can time it right, that would be the best. Like, just like they're like, oh, what's gonna happen? Oh no!
No, not again. No, that's impossible.
Ah, right when he was about to get hit with it. Oh, it's terrible.
I saw that one. Wasted. You're really enjoying that, aren't you?
Yeah, this is power I should never have been given.
No, you really shouldn't have. I need to fix that. Am I coming across like quiet to you, or is it just me?
Nope. Sound fine to me.
I'm going to scoot into the mic.
Okay. You do what you do, man.
Scoot it in a little.
You do you.
Yeah, I am.
Gross.
Not like that.
Gross.
Well, you ready to do a show?
No. Yes. Yes.
You sure?
No.
Okay.
Who's doing the intro? Are you doing the intro? We're just doing the intro. What are we doing for the intro?
I'll do it. I'll just jump right into the show. Does that sound good to you?
Okay. Don't want to do an intro. It's fine.
Okay. No, go ahead and do an intro. It's all you, man.
Don't want to do an intro.
Oh, okay. That's fine. Welcome to Azeroth Roundtable, episode 149. My name is Ben Bumhofer, and that pouty doesn't want to do an intro with me is John Jagger. How's it going, John?
Hi, Ben.
Hey, John.
Guess who's sick again?
Me, kinda.
Me too. Great.
Right.
It's been a week and it's continuing. This is fantastic.
Yeah, but you know what? We're still showing up.
That's right. We're dedicated.
I'd rather be sleeping right now. Well, not really.
Not me. I'm excited to be here.
Yeah, well, you're having a really busy week too.
I am having a busy week. It's a fun week though.
That's good.
It's good times. Ben, I have no idea what we're going to talk about today.
Oh, I know.
And so before we talk about the thing I have no idea what we're going to talk about, I need to air some grievances.
Uh-oh, what did I do?
you did nothing.
Yeah. Wait, in a good I did nothing way, or as in a you didn't do it so it's your fault way?
I logged into the Legion Alpha.
Oh, okay. I did too.
Just before the show.
Me too.
I had important business I needed to, I had to take care of. Because I had heard that they changed the Rogue class hall.
Oh, really?
Yes. And they did.
Where is it? Is it still in the sewer?
So now what you do, if you are a rogue, you go to the wine and cheese shop in Dalaran, and you present a seal to the guy at the counter there.
Like a sea lion seal, like with flippers and stuff?
Just like a seal.
Oh, okay.
Like what you turn in for extra
rolls.
Like
a coin.
Yeah. And then it gives you access to this little side door that's in the cheese shop.
Okay.
And you click that, and then you go to a loading screen, and then they plop you right in the shitty sewer.
That doesn't sound cool at all.
No, it starts really awesome now. And, like, that's the thing. I was so excited. I was like, yes, they changed it. Finally, they're kind of getting it that, like, we're heroes that defeated the Lich King.
Yeah.
We have saved the world countless times. We're the heroes of Azeroth. Yeah, we're the ones that are a little more out for ourselves than everybody else, but that's
just
okay.
Okay.
And so naturally, we live in the sewer next to all the poop.
Well, I mean, if you're really out for yourself, are you going to be spending a lot of money on accommodations?
Yes.
Okay.
Look in Dalaran, find the tallest tower. That's where I'll be.
I bet you that's where mages can be.
Brewmaster Wansu in the chat room has made the suggestion that perhaps you now go in through the wine and cheese shop because of the outcry from all the rogues.
Because of all the wine?
Because of all the wine.
Hmm. You know, there is that possibility, but at this point, I think what they should do is just completely redesign the class hall and put it somewhere else. Because we know that it is going through a secret passage in the wine and cheese shop, right?
Right.
So it can really be anywhere, just like some sort of underground secret place.
Okay, here's the thing. I don't
Isn't that better than the sewer?
I don't mind the sewer. Let me get right down to it. I don't mind the sewer if they can make a case for it being a nice-ish place.
Okay.
Like, if they can suggest that was the most ideal place for the rogues to conduct business, I'm all for it. The problem, and I'm going to mute because I'm going to cough.
Cough, cough, cough. Cough.
Ben, now that I'm back.
Hi.
Is that it's dark, there's spider webs everywhere, and there's poo water running through the road that you're there.
So, if it didn't have the poo water, would you be okay with it?
I'd be more okay with it. Now, okay. They did do some things that I like. So, before I go all crazy on them, here's the stuff I like.
Okay.
Thing I like, number one, there's more gold in the treasure room now.
Okay.
And more artifacts. Stealing them.
Over the course of the expansion, would you even like it if it just accumulated more and more throughout the whole expansion?
No, fill that thing up early. Keep it
okay.
Full. So that's cool. There's another secret exit into Dalaran that goes behind like a bookcase. That's pretty cool.
That is cool.
And you know that tunnel that leads out that little side entrance of Dalaran?
Yeah, one of my favorite places to actually enter.
They have stuck a wooden plank down there so you can make people walk the plank out of Dalaran.
That's kind of cool.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
They're making progress, Ben. It doesn't make it clean. Make the waters pristine and maybe
like
not.
And
yeah,
stuff, right?
Yeah. Just make it nice.
Yeah, but not like poo fountains.
Make it a nice sewer.
Bring in the interior decorator. Maybe hang some tapestries.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, well, I can see that, but
so,
I mean...
Here's the other stuff. Here's the other. So, there were two things I also needed to test while I was there.
Mm-hmm.
I needed to see how I felt about the class hall. The good news is I feel better about the class hall. Okay. The bad news is I'm still not on board with the decisions that were made. Two, I had to try the pull out a pistol and shoot somebody skill. Because that's a really cool skill idea. And if you remember, the last time we talked about this, you pulled out, like, the most generic level one rifle for pistol shot and shot him with a big old rifle, and it looked horrible.
Yeah.
Now you actually pull out a pistol. The pistol still doesn't look very good.
Like, are you expecting piratey, like flintlock?
It kind of looks like that's what they were going for. I still don't think it looks very good.
Okay.
And the animation is still the rifle animation, so it looks like you shoot out of the handle of the gun. And nice. You kind of do this weird thing where you throw, like, both arms up in the air when you shoot it. So you really just don't look like you know how to operate a weapon.
So you're like, I don't know.
Shot at you. and that's a problem. So I think we're going to get a new animation. I don't think that's something that I need to be like, you need to fix it. I think they know. I think
I think they've said as much, actually. I'm not sure about that. I don't follow the Rogue stuff.
The other thing I needed to test was to see if Grappling Hook, which sounded so awesome on paper, had become a cool thing. It has not.
Do you think that they were just trying to play Assassin's Creed Syndicate?
No. It's really dumb. And, like, here's the problem, and this is what I'm... Okay, if you want my genuine, like, kind of jokes about Rogue's comments aside, genuine concern about Legion is this. And this is the tricky part, and this is why I typically don't play the alpha and the beta all that much, is because I let these little things bother me too much. But my concern
is...
It's
better to let them bother you in the actual game.
My concern is this. There's a lot of things that they're talking about being in this game that sound really, really cool when talked about. And then when you experience it as they've put it in the game, it has been a letdown almost every single time. So like they said, we're giving Rogues a grappling hook. And I was like, yes, that sounds amazing. A friggin' grappling hook. All right. And what it equates to is... In about the range that a mage can blink, you select a spot on the ground and your character jumps awkwardly into the air over to that spot, and there's the sound of a chain.
So it's not like grappling hook, like I can get up there, it's just forward.
Correct. If you aim it at the side of anything or anywhere, it just says you can't go there. So it's basically like a controlled blink.
Yeah.
With a much longer recharge.
That's not even a grappling hook. That's a... Gosh, it's something really lame and boring is what it is. It's not a grappling hook. It's a pulley hook or something.
Yeah, it's a dumb jump is what I would have called the talent, as it appears. A dumb jump and the sound of a chain. Like, that's all we have right now. So, I don't know. I hope it gets cooler. Like, a lot of this stuff still being worked on, a lot of this stuff, you know, we'll see how it goes and all that, but right now, every time I get in, I'm like, oh, is it cool yet? And it's not cool yet, so...
Okay, hold on, I gotta jump in here, because the chat room's saying stuff. So, okay, a reverse death grip, okay, makes sense. Harpoon gun, that actually makes it sound cool, but from what you're describing, it's not awesome at all. But kind of put those two things together, and... John, you're going to like this because I'm going to, you know, kind of tiptoe into a topic that I know you love to talk about that we don't really talk about on the show very often.
Okay.
Does that sound kind of like Sonya's grapple fly towards an enemy thing?
Yes, that would be a grappling hook.
Okay. I'm kind of changing topics slightly because I think you were done anyway, right?
Yeah, I was.
Okay. I think... that a lot of the abilities that they're putting into the game are coming from the heroes from Heroes of the Storm. Now, I haven't done a lot of playing, but I've done, you know, a little bit more in the alpha this week than normal. So I went through the Paladin Retribution starting artifact stuff. I went through the Frost Death Knight stuff. And here's the funny thing. When I was playing on the Death Knight, I swear I had all of Arthas's abilities from Heroes of the Storm. You have the cloudy thing. You have the ice spikes shooting up from the ground.
Okay.
You can call in Syndragosa.
What?
Like, seriously, Syndragosa comes in and clears, like, the way.
Hold on. Wait a minute, Ben.
Yeah. Frost Death Knight.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Ben, were you playing Heroes of the Storm and you thought you were playing WoW?
Well, if Arthas is suddenly a Tauren and running around in Dalaran, then yeah, I was totally playing Heroes of the Storm.
Damn it, that sounds really cool.
Yeah, I'll tell you, Frost Dead Knights, I had a lot of fun going through that little like open questing area. So here's another thing. I just finished doing some of the Paladin stuff, and it seemed kind of Tyrael-ish. Like, there's one move where you throw a sword, and then you hit that again, and then you teleport to the sword. There's also an ability that gives you 4 seconds of, like, rushing on a horse. So there's your Diablo, like, Crusader in there, too. So it seems like they're actually kind of putting a lot of these abilities into WoW.
That is a really smart idea. And it perhaps makes me wish that there was a really awesome rogue in Heroes of the Storm from which they could steal some really cool abilities.
Like, what if you start throwing alchemy potions and stuff?
Because right now, an argument could perhaps be made that all the things that should be cool about the rogue right now actually are not cool at all and are a big disappointment. Oh, once again, Wansu, he should have just been on the show tonight. Saving me, Greymane. And that's true, except the problem is, like, Greymane's not that great in human form. So yeah. Unless they're going to let us just suddenly all turn into werewolves, which I'm for, let's be clear, I am pro this decision, then there's nothing to it. Like, I would be willing to throw a cocktail at people and have it explode, though. That'd be fun.
Like a Molotov?
Yeah.
That'd be okay. I'd be okay with that. Can you imagine rogue tanking? It's like a mixture of Drunken Master, but, you know, throw the fire on the ground and all that stuff.
Yeah.
That'd be kind of cool. Yeah. But no, Wanzu's right. You know, that's who I thought of. That's why I was like, you know, the alchemy bottles, because that's something that Greymane does, right?
Yeah, he throws a Gilnean cocktail.
Yeah. Yeah. See, totally.
And then he, you know what he does, Ben? Going back to another discussion we had, he turns into a worgen and he attacks people with claws.
What?
Not magic.
Yeah, but to keep it up, one of the talent choices that you get as an enhancement shaman is you can like shoot an earthquake that splits and moves people. It's like, seriously, that's a thrall ability that you have. So, I don't know. Do you think that these are because they're trying to make the gameplay actually more active and everything than just, okay, I'm going to stand here and hit these buttons? Because a lot of the stuff is kind of directional.
I think that might be the case. I think that's smart. I think WoW needs a more active combat system. And, you know, I think that Heroes of the Storm has this nice benefit of being a new game that has very few moves. And as a result, it's very easy to get in there and say, oh, man, look at this move. This move is so cool. I wish I could do that in WoW. You know, you look at Thrall as a shaman and you see him in Heroes do that move and you think, man, it'd be cool if I could do that in WoW. So it's very cool that we're getting to see that translate over. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think that's exciting. That makes me want to play every class, except the one I've chosen, apparently.
Well, it's still an alpha, so there's a chance. You know that they've reworked a whole bunch of stuff.
Yes.
So there's a possibility. But no, it's one of the neat things that giving us those artifact weapons and actually, like, turning us into the heroes, which BlizzCon 2016 prediction, your character will be in Heroes of the Storm. I'm gonna do
you
that
already
until it happens.
Won the thing, Ben.
I know, I'm not in it this year. I understand that. But it's one of those things that I don't know, I'm feeling more heroic when I'm playing the alpha. In fact, going back to the Death Knight, the combat animations are really cool. And I mean, granted, I haven't done a whole lot of Frost Death Knight, like, fighting and everything, but I mean, he's like swinging both swords down at the same time, doing stuff, and it looks really cool. So I really think that Alpha is a big revamp of abilities. And considering that, you know, like when you actually go in and you fill out your bar, I have all these missing spaces on my just main action bar because there's so few abilities.
I know, it's so really nice.
It is. I really like it because I actually know what each thing does and the appropriate time to actually use it. So because of that, they're able to give you those really cool special things. So good job.
Good job, Blizzard.
Yeah.
I'm all for that.
Yeah, I thought you'd be super stoked about Frost DK's having Arthas's abilities. And I mean, it does kind of fit that I was, you know, walking around with pieces of Frostmourne. So,
yeah, I mean, that's cool. Yeah. I think for me, though, like, that's the big thing is just, like, I have yet to hit that point with the Rogue that I was so excited about on paper where it's cool in the game. And I'm waiting for that. I log in every now and then, and I wait to see if it's cool, and it just hasn't been yet. But like you said, we're very early on still, unfortunately.
Yeah, I mean, all the specs aren't even unlocked yet.
We're unfortunately very early still, and there's a long ways to go. So I could be pleasantly surprised. I like the idea. Like, when I was running around testing the gun animation, like, it felt cool as a rogue to be just running around and pulling out a pistol and shooting these ghosts that died in one hit. Like, just that felt awesome.
Mm-hmm.
But it just, the problem was the animation looked dumb. The gun looked dumb. Like, so there's that cool thing, like, I'm doing an awesome thing, but it looks really stupid and silly right now. And Blizzard, you know, polish is one thing that you should never really have to worry about with Blizzard.
Mm-hmm.
The only reason I ever do with WoW is because we are talking about a game that's 11 years old.
Yeah, I mean, can see that.
There are still moments where it's like, you know, they try to do an action sequence and they're like, come on, you gotta jump on the horse. And you right-click the horse and your character goes, wee! All up into the air and then whew, right down onto the horse and you're
oh, yeah,
like,
that's great.
You're like, all right, that 10-year-old game, folks. 10-year-old game. Just remind yourself of that.
No, we just got the new character models, so that means that, you know, they can articulate better. So who knows? Maybe we'll have a jumping on the back of the horse animation.
Maybe.
Yeah. I mean, imagine if you're a Tauren, it's like jump on the horse, and then you jump on and then the horse just kind of falls over. That could work.
Yeah.
Maybe. Yeah.
Sure.
Then you just get up and run. I mean, that's how that works. But I mean, if you're talking about polish, if you want to feel a little better, going back to the Frost Death Knight, when I did do Sindragosa, Sindragosa was standing and like sliding in the air, and then the wings sprouted at the very end.
Oh, right. So, I'm a dragon. I can fly.
Yeah. Just woo, that was fun. So. Yeah.
I should be less concerned about Alpha Jank. I really should. But yeah. I'm not sure that the gameplay is there yet for me either. So
okay. Well, how many classes have you had a chance to try out?
Rogue! You only need one class, Ben.
Really? Because I'm telling you all these cool things in other classes.
Yeah, well, I can do all those cool things in Heroes of the Storm.
Yeah, I know. And I can do them in WoW.
Boo.
I will say, though, one thing that I thought was kind of weird, and I don't know if this is, you know, going to stay or not, or if it's working as intended or what they want to do with it. But again, just tried out the Paladin tonight. And so far, of all of the different classes that I've played and all the different specs, they're the only ones that still have a buff that they can actually cast. So they have three versions of their blessing again, as opposed to just Kings and Might. They have Kings, Might, and Wisdom again.
Okay.
And you can cast all three on yourself.
Okay.
So I'm like, okay, that's great.
Bless yourself.
We'll stick with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sounds good.
Yeah. But anyways, that does get me into kind of what I wanted to talk a little bit about tonight. And keep in mind, again, we don't want to do any sort of story spoilers on the show, just because, you know, we're not jerks like that.
Right.
So anything from this point on consider it as hypothetical because we're looking at both sides of a coin here and things like that.
Okay.
So you really have no idea what I really want to talk about. And I'm kind of excited about that. So something that's, you know, you and I have discussed either on air or off air, you know, here and there, ever since Legion was announced, when they talked about the different artifact weapons that you would be getting, we were wondering what would actually happen to those characters that are actually holding on to those weapons, like, right. you know, Thrall with Doomhammer or Tyrion with Ashbringer or, you know, what's going on with the shards of Frostmourne, you know, things like that. So after going through and playing some of those to find out what actually does happen, I kind of want to get your take on, you know, just how important some of these characters actually are to the universe versus like how they should be handled going forward. I mean, just kind of as an example, Karen Bloodhoof, not exactly the biggest character in the world, but his death was actually pretty impactful, even though people didn't ever see it happen because it happened.
Right. Some people are probably right now like, spoilers! You said yeah. you weren't going to spoil anything! And then you say, well, he died in Cataclysm, and they go, what?
Who's he? Yeah. It's one of those things. So, you know, what is your thoughts on Thrall? Like, we've talked about it before. You like Thrall. He's a good character, right?
I like Thrall.
Okay, he's not exactly a good character as he used to be, but you like Thrall.
Sure.
Do you look at him as Green Jesus as other people have?
He's kind of Green Jesus.
Okay. So, going forward from this point, we look at what he's done, where he's gone, and is this a character that, I mean, I don't want to say needs to die, but, like, if he died, would that work better than if he was still around afterwards? You know?
Then. So, okay. I fell into a trap. I started reading chat as you were talking.
Okay.
And they started talking about multiple other characters. And I have to confess, I forgot which character we were actually talking about versus which character the chat room is talking about right now.
We're talking about Thrall.
Thrall! Okay, good. Green Jesus. Great.
Thanks, John.
It's
so rewarding talking to you, knowing that you're paying attention.
I reacted to your Thrall talk, and then I look down. It's Nightvale's fault. He's in the chat room, and he's just throwing out characters like they're candy. They're talking about Superman now. Like, it's just gone places, okay? I'm a little sick. I'm a little distracted. It's fine.
I know. I'll allow it this time because you're
so chat. Thanks a lot.
And they're congratulating
chat
themselves.
Hey, you
good
got
job.
Me in trouble. Okay, so Thrall, Green Jesus, should he die? How would that make me feel if he died? Because so this is kind of going back to a problem that I've had with the game for a long time, which is how do you move the story forward when it feels like we learn the same lesson every expansion, right? Yeah. Every expansion, it's about we hate the Horde, we hate the Alliance. Oh no, a third faction.
Let's kill it.
Let's band together, or we'll be destroyed. We're friends. New expansion, right back to it. Yeah. Like, that's the never-ending cycle. And so how do you have characters learn we have to work together? And how many times do they have to learn that before they genuinely have to work together? Like, even Jaina, they had to do some really drastic things to get her to do anything that wasn't about peace. And I don't think that was good storytelling with Jaina. I mean, the book was good, but I don't like where Jaina's at. I liked her better before. And I tend to root for villains a lot of the time. So I think
that's not why you chose the Horde, because the Horde is the good guy.
That's right. Horde are the real good guys of World of Warcraft. That won't cause
everyone
a
knows
stir.
That.
Glad I said that out loud. And so that's kind of the thing is Thrall not being war chief, I feel like the decision to have him step down and give that to Vol'jin was very much this idea of Thrall was at a place where, like, it just wouldn't make sense to have Alliance and Horde fighting each other with Thrall in charge. It still kind of doesn't with Vol'jin in charge, because he tends to be the more rational of the leaders.
Yeah.
You know, I feel like him or Bane, like, a lot of those would be the more level-headed. Sylvanas is a little more inclined to maybe get up to some nefarious deeds.
Yeah. Then there's Gallywix, who the hell knows what's going on with his head.
Who knows? We don't even know why Gallywix is a faction leader.
Because they needed a goblin.
Like, he's the only faction leader that I think has straight up tried to murder the war chief and still got made faction leader. Yeah. Like,
I respect what you're doing.
Like,
here's a copper.
Yeah, and you get to lead everybody. Way to go, Gallywix. So, I don't know. Like, it's one of those things where I think they don't... Deaths of characters need to be impactful, and they need to serve the story. When you kill off a character because they're no longer interesting, that doesn't have a good impact. Because part of getting invested in a character is getting invested in the closing of that character's loop, whether that is through death or through them achieving what they want.
Yeah. With, like, take a character like Arthas. You know, really great start, goes through, you know, Warcraft 3 and everything, finally ends in Lich King.
Yeah.
Great arc. You killed him. I mean, granted, he was the villain at the end, but it was an interesting tale. Whereas, I could be wrong in this, but you're basically saying that Thrall was force for good, really cool guy, stepped down as war chief, and then he's just kind of stagnated.
A little bit. I will say there's some stuff I know about Thrall going into this expansion that I feel like they have found a way, at least from the little bit that I know, to make him interesting again, to at least give a little bit of struggle to him. But to me, if it was just the case, and for all I know, this is what they do. Like I said, I only know a very little bit. If it was just the case of, oh, let's just kill him so we can have a death, that's not very fulfilling.
Yeah.
As a player, like, even if you don't like Thrall and you think he's showing up way too often, like, you want his end to mean something more than just, like, and then he died. Like, it needs to have some sort of impact and importance. Yeah. So, you know, we've talked a lot about the potential death of main characters in this expansion a lot. And kind of that fear, in fact, we did a poll of it, that fear of it going into Game of Thrones, where it's just like suddenly nobody's safe. We could kill anybody any moment from now.
Exactly.
And I don't think that's actually fun, and I don't think that actually fits in World of Warcraft. I think World of Warcraft's strength is its characters. Arthas is the best villain in that series because, I know people are going to argue with that, but...
No, he is.
He is. Because he had multiple games to win as a bad guy and to be this sometimes covert, sometimes overt force on the world. And he got to breathe as a character. And if you go around and you just start killing characters left and right, then the only thing that allows you to do is, okay, well, now we need to introduce new characters to replace the ones that we killed off. And you're less invested in those typically.
Yeah, see, I kind of agree with you on that. With Garrosh was a fantastic character as well. He is one of the few characters that's actually been introduced into the lore through WoW to begin with, and then, you know, grew into this grand epic character who, again, ultimately turned into a villain. I mean, so far, I guess the best characters are villains because the heroes just stick around.
Well, unless
you're Karen Bloodhoof.
It's a testament to where Blizzard's strength in writing characters tends to be. You know, Blizzard tends to tell more compelling stories around their villains than their heroes because Blizzard frequently is too hands-on hips, goody-good, Captain America, Superman with their heroes. Like, the heroes in the Blizzard universe are almost always that lawful good character. And lawful good is frequently boring as hell. Not to say that it's always that. You can find examples and exceptions across the board. But when you think of the really big good guys, that tends to be where it falls into.
Yeah.
I think the reason that you see people who really like characters like Sylvanas is you have that more sympathetic character that's got maybe some darker motives, that's got maybe some questionable morals. And I think people really want that, but they don't get it very often from Blizzard, because it's too easy for Blizzard to say, oh, rather than be, you know, this chaotic good or, you know, chaotic neutral character, we're going to just take Sylvanas and make her bad. Mm-hmm. Like, and now all of a sudden they have another intriguing villain instead of an intriguing hero.
Yeah. No, I can see that. And I mean, one of the things with Thrall is that, I mean, if he does end up dying, then, like you said, it's got to be something impactful, something good. Otherwise, it just kind of cheapens the whole thing. And then it does turn into a Game of Thrones thing where, I mean, granted, from what I've read in that and, you know, seen on the show and everything, most of that stuff is impactful, except for the times where it's just kind of like, you know, just a blatant, oh, and he's dead because, you know, yeah, shock value. But it kind of comes down to a lot of how they present it in the game, which, again, is a big deal of, as long as it's in the game. Because again, Karen Bloodhoof is dead. Why do I keep coming back to him? Because guess what? A lot of people don't even know who he is. We have our Elders stuff coming up soon. And I think that's the quest line where you can go and honor him.
Yeah, I think so.
Which, it's really cool. But if you don't know the significance, who cares at this point?
Yeah. It's really tricky, and you know, I really hope this isn't just the expansion of we just start wiping out characters left and right.
Mm-hmm.
But we'll see. I don't know. I hope not. You know, I would think after an entire expansion was devoted to killing one of the faction leaders, and then he remained kind of a villain going into the next expansion, even, I would think that hopefully Blizzard would kind of push the brakes a little bit on the let's make the faction leaders all really bad. Mm-hmm. And I also, and here's another interesting thought, and I'd like to get your thoughts on this.
Okay.
We keep finding ourselves, and it looks like this expansion is going to be another case of this,
mm-hmm,
where the Alliance and the Horde are this unreasonable force combating each other. I almost said combattling. That should be a word. That's pretty good.
It is. Combattling.
Combattling. They're combattling each other.
Yeah, totally.
And we're on the outsides going, you guys shouldn't do that. We're going to go do the really important stuff
because,
mm-hmm, you guys shouldn't do that.
And then we'll sing your praises. Good job, heroes. We're going to go back and beat them up some more.
Right. But for some reason, despite that, despite the fact that we're saying, like, oh man, they're just not with it. They're not, we're going to go be the heroes and they're going to fight each other. We're still living in their city. We're still for the Horde, for the Alliance. Like, we're still supposed to have this faction pride. We're still supposed to be very unified on what we do and all of that. And it always seems kind of weird to me that they, story-wise, frequently put us at odds with our own faction, and yet somehow continue to justify this two-faction system, when it's felt like for at least the past 3 or 4 expansions that we almost exist outside of it. Yeah. Like, if you were to get down to your character's lore level, I don't know if my character would actually be a member of the Horde, because we haven't been given a real good reason to continue to be members of the Horde.
Mm-hmm.
The Alliance maybe a little more so. They've been a little more unified the past couple expansions. But if you're a Horde player, like, you've continued to watch the leadership there make questionable decisions and not want to be a part of it. And, you know, it kind of, one thing they kept saying about Legion was this idea of, no, your class is kind of your faction in this one, because the Alliance and Horde are going at it like they always do. And now it's the top members of each class are going to have to be the ones that save the world.
But that makes no sense, because you're in your class with members of the opposite faction.
Yeah. And it's once again just illustrating that issue of, like, I kind of want to go back to the days of faction pride. Like,
mm-hmm,
and that doesn't mean they have to be at each other's throats. Like, it doesn't have to be, I love my faction because they hate your faction.
Yeah.
You should just be able to be proud of the faction you belong to.
Well, it goes back to, again, Lich King. The most faction pride you ever had as a Horde is the Wrathgate cinematic.
Yeah.
I'm with you on
even
that.
Even though it quickly turns. But I mean, yeah. Do you feel like that? Do you feel like the game has pushed you away from the Horde and playing through on your Alliance tune? Did you feel that way on the Alliance ever?
Well, I will say it's really weird playing an Alliance tune and fighting the Horde every now and then. Especially, you know, if you've been playing the Horde your whole Warcraft career. But one of the weirdest things that I felt is, so you see the cinematic for Legion, right? Really cool. You see Sylvanas working with Varian. Explosions everywhere. She uses all of her Heroes of the Storm abilities. Mm-hmm. See, it's happening.
Yep.
Then all of a sudden, so I went through the mage starter stuff, got my artifact weapon because, you know, I'm a mage. And I picked, what was it? Stormheim, I think? And like the opening intro, the quest line talks, sorry if you think this is spoilers, it's not. The opening quest line talks about how we have to like stop the Alliance from doing something. It totally broke it for me. I mean, I know there's going to be some sort of intro into the Broken Isles and all that stuff. Who knows what's going to happen? Maybe there's some sort of betrayal that does happen. We haven't seen that yet.
Right.
But, you know, it starts you off in Dalaran. You take this quest, you do this, you choose where you go, and then all of a sudden someone says, hey, we have to go kill these people that you just saw a cinematic for, that we were working together and things were pretty cool. So, you know, as I'm sitting there, if I'm RPing as my character, I'm like, why are we doing this now? I mean, it doesn't make sense. And the fact that you start off, you see this giant tower, the Tower of Sargeras, right? Big giant thing.
Yeah.
Demons pouring out of it. Where does anyone who's actually sane think, hey, you know what? Let's kill the Alliance and then get all the glory for ourselves.
Right.
Like, it doesn't make any sense at that point. I mean, I can see it, like, you know, a little bit more of a faction pride during, like, Siege of Orgrimmar or something where, yeah, they were nice and let us all, you know, like, have our capital and stuff like that.
Right.
But even more so, we were united against part of our faction. You would think that there wouldn't be that much tension from there. And then all of a sudden we go into Warlords, and why we're fighting each other at that point, who knows? I still don't know.
I mean, the nice thing about Pandaria was that you had that, like, it started slow. So it started, we have a new landmass, new resources, we need these, and to not let the Alliance have these. Mm-hmm. It introduced that conflict organically, and then it was like, oh wait, there's a bigger force we have to band together to fight.
Yeah, it's like, oh, the Shah, this is kind of cool, you know, ancient evil-y stuff, okay. And then all of a sudden, Grosh just is a gigantic jerk.
Yeah, but this time, it, like you said, we have that reason to unite right away.
Yeah.
And we're not doing it. And so I'm seeing in the chat people saying, like, that's why the classes are coming together. That's the reason for the class halls and all of that. But I think where the issue is, and what Ben is saying, is that he, as a player, as a member of that class and that kind of quasi-third faction, is still going off and fighting the Alliance. So they're still pulling you into that story, even though, as a player, we're looking at it and going, this doesn't make any sense for us to be doing.
I mean, it's coming down to one of those things where it's like, kill the Alliance! Except Bill over there, he's another mage, he's pretty cool.
Right, and
kill the Alliance!
Like, here's the thing, too. I don't care if Varian Wrynn came to my house and murdered my mother. Like, when it comes to full-on, like,
that'd be pretty bad.
Demonic invasion and extinction, you don't then turn around and say, well, we don't need them. Like, you don't make the decision of, like, well, we're going to wipe out the entire... We're going to lose the entire planet to, in turn, get revenge for mom. Dear old mom.
Look, your mom's a very nice woman. I'll put that right there. I mean, in the off chance that she's listening,
she's not.
Mrs. Jagger, I don't want you to die.
She's not listening.
You're awesome.
And that, I think that's what's frustrating for me. And it's been frustrating for a little while, is it... it used to feel like as a faction we went off and we did our own thing, and it caused us to occasionally kind of come into conflict with one another. Yeah. Now it feels like, hey, we have to fight each other because this is Warcraft and that's what you do. And it feels artificial. It doesn't feel true to the story or the world mm-hmm. they're presenting or anything like that. And as a player, I feel outside of it. So anytime I get a quest that's like, hey, go kill the Alliance. It used to be back in the day, I was like, yeah, it's time. I'm going to go get them. But now as a player, I'm just like, ugh, do I have to? Can I opt out of this quest? Because it doesn't make sense for my character to do at this point.
Yeah. No, and that's one of the things. Especially if you play cross-factions, seeing it from both sides, it doesn't make sense. I mean, if you go back to like kind of the basics of it, a lot of it is, you know, for the Alliance, it's they're invading, they're attacking, kill those mongrels and, you know, things like that. Horde, it's more of a defense of, well, this is kind of our home now, don't kill us.
Right.
But at this point, all the factions and, you know, the species, whatever you want to call them, they're all pretty much settled. It just doesn't make sense.
Well, good.
So,
I'm not the only one that thinks that way.
Totally not. But, okay, something that's, again, Brewmaster Wanzu, thanks for totally tossing stuff in there. What if there was, you know, storytelling-wise, something that made the other faction think that, you know, there was a conflict going on? You know, not that there necessarily was, like, any sort of betrayal or anything like that, but, like, maybe an Onyxia-level, I don't know, manipulation going on.
Right. What if there's, like, a puppet master pulling the strings? Mm-hmm. I think that's an interesting story. I think they're going to have to do a very good job convincing me, because what they have presented and what they have shown of this game so far is very much like, this is the biggest invasion, this is the biggest threat, this is the worst that's ever been. And like I said, you're going to have to make a very compelling reason why me as a player feels the need to suddenly make this conflict about the other people trying to protect the planet instead of the invading force. Because to me, the cool story in WoW, the cool part that I've looked forward in WoW, is that Burning Legion is finally here, they're finally invading, and everybody on Azeroth who spent all this time fighting each other and all this time at war and all of that are unified and fighting them back. Mm-hmm. That sounds awesome, that sounds epic. It's kind of generic, not a lot of intrigue to it, but you know what? Like, that's your payoff, that's your cool moment. And if it turns out to be like, okay, well, here's that setup, but no, they're just still fighting each other, that's boring to me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So then we go into territory that we've had before, which is how do we, you know, end that conflict and move forward?
Right. And 'cause that's ultimately what it'll be, right? You know, the resolution is ultimately going to be, but then they saw the error in their ways and they decided to unify and fight the Burning Legion. And
then punch each other afterwards.
Lo and behold, they won. And then there was a nice little meeting and they said, hey, we should be nicer to each other. And then they got Christmas gifts for one another during Winterfell. And everybody was really happy. And then a new expansion came out. And then everybody got real mad.
And then someone played a practical joke on someone else.
Yeah, it's the cycle. And I get that it's the cycle, but it doesn't have to be the cycle.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, heck, the next expansion could be all about peace talks and, I don't know, some other faction trying to break them up because they don't want to mix or something. I mean, that is a potential interesting story if you look at it. Like,
what if
the Grim Totem Tauren
what
break up? I don't know.
What if the goblins create a trade blockade around Stormwind?
No, John. No.
But
no.
The Alliance Senate can't agree that they should be disbanded.
You're a horrible person.
So they send two Death Knights.
No, two paladins.
So totally they send paladins. Two paladins
mm-hmm.
to negotiate, causing the goblins to disband their trade dispute.
I hate you.
Look, what if the taxation of trade routes...
What trade routes?
The trade routes between Goldshire and Stormwind.
Okay, well, first of all, let's put it this way. Let's put it in gameplay turns. Terms, not turns. If you ride on the road, you have to pay gold. It's a new gold sink anytime you're actually riding on the road.
Right, they're taxing it.
Yes.
Because it's exactly. A trade route.
Yep, every now and then as you're you know, riding a horse or a wolf or a, you know, whatever mount, you just hear this ting.
And it's like gotten way expensive because they're greedy, right?
Yeah, totally, because they're goblins, right?
Right, yes.
Yeah.
Oh, we definitely need racism in this.
Yeah.
And so then they're like, we need to do something about these goblins. They send the paladins in, mm-hmm. but the goblins try to kill the paladins. Mm-hmm. The paladins meet up with a gnome.
Oh, totally a gnome. Short. Maybe a little tall for his race.
But... He's a water gnome.
Water gnome.
Yeah, because mm-hmm. there's a whole race of gnomes that live in that lake.
Yeah, that you totally makes sense. You know, they have underwater, because, you know, they build that stuff.
Right. Mm-hmm. And it turns into a full-on invasion, but they can't get word mm-mm. to Stormwind to say that it's an invasion. But the queen of Goldshire, one of them.
Of Goldshire.
Yeah, there's
of
a
the
lot.
Of the little tiny there, town?
There's a lot of queens in Goldshire.
No. It's the goblin town in Daenerys. They get there.
Okay.
That's where they end up.
So the queen of Goldshire manages to make it to... a city that we're talking about, and she gets the chancellor, we'll say.
Mm-hmm.
They had chancellors in Warcraft times, right?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so he is going to try to become the supreme chancellor.
I hate you so much.
To help solve this trade dispute. There's a lot of politics in the next expansion, Ben.
Yeah, okay, I can see that.
It's going to be a high octane political drama.
Okay.
Great. But it ends with two paladins fighting a death knight.
Okay. Well, or maybe we move over to something similar to, like, say, House of Cards.
Maybe it's a demon hunter.
Oh, there you go.
No, it's a death knight.
Yeah. But he uses a staff for some reason.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe they fight a demon hunter. But it turns out the Supreme Chancellor's a Death Knight.
No.
Nobody knew.
No, they'd be the same class. They'd both be Demon Hunters or they'd both be Death Knights.
Well, no.
Yeah.
They're just like a different... Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, see?
So he's like a Blood Death Knight. And the Supreme Chancellor's like a Plague Death Knight.
Yeah, that works. And can shoot lightning for some reason.
Yeah.
Oh, no. We're going back to vanilla type stuff. They're both shaman.
Dark shaman.
Yeah. And one of them shoots lightning for some reason. Oh, God.
It's going to be the best expansion ever.
Or the worst.
There's no way it can fail. Look, this gnome character I've got in my mind is going to be real awesome.
Does he talk weird?
Yeah, he's going to speak in broken English, and he's going to be completely CGI.
Wait, isn't the entire game CGI?
Yeah, but he's going to be extra CGI.
Oh, okay.
He's going to use the old model.
Oh, okay, that works.
He's going to have, like, 7 polygons.
Yep, and in cutscenes, whenever you're talking to him, the characters are looking slightly to the left or, like, above his eyeline.
Yeah, they're like, oh, really? And they're looking, like, a little too intently at him. Like, you can mm-hmm. tell they're trying to just, like, they're really, like, as he's talking, it's really intense.
Yeah, exactly. No matter what he says, very intense.
There's a lot to look forward to in this
expansion. And what's even better... is all the hand-to-hand combat animations are going to be redone. And no matter what's going on everywhere else, those are like 90 frames a second. They're going to look really good.
Yeah, it's going to be good. Yeah. It's going to be good, everybody. So there you go. our predictions for the next post-Legion expansion.
Yeah, if you want to call it that. So what's the name, John?
The Death Knight Menace.
Oh, okay. How about the Phantom Class?
We'll think about it. We'll decide.
Okay, we'll brainstorm.
There's plenty of time. Plenty of time. We still got this boring action-packed Legion expansion to get through before we can get to the exciting trade disputes. Like, you're going to come out knowing something about taxation and trade law.
Well, the best part is the quest line that they're going to put in there when you have to actually address the Senate and get a vote. Like, going around and going through dialogue trees to talk to different senators to sway them to your side.
Yeah.
It's going to be fantastic.
Here's the twist, Ben.
Yeah.
It takes place in the past.
Oh. Time travel.
No. It's just, like, this is what happened before.
Oh, okay. So just, like we're pausing the current timeline, and then all of our characters will just be younger.
Yeah.
Okay. That makes sense. Like, what, say, 20 years younger?
Yeah.
Okay. I like this. We can do that.
And there's going to be a lot of cameos.
It's
going to be like Al the Mage, meet Uther the Lightbringer. And you'll be like, pleased to meet ya.
And then Uther will be like, hello.
But Uther's going to be real cool.
Oh, of course. Really cool.
Yeah.
Al the Mage, though, she's not going to be, like, really lame, is she?
It's going to be fully voice activated, too.
She's going to sound like a 18th century English, like, street urchin?
Sometimes you'll have accents, sometimes you won't. And yes, you'll sound like a street urchin.
Hello! Hello! I'm going to cast a fireball now.
Shine your shoes, love.
This is wizard.
No,
I'll try spinning. That's a good trick.
That turned Australian. Weird.
Crikey.
Okay. So, but we don't want to give too much away. No spoilers.
No,
here.
No. I mean, we do have, you know, inside information, but we can't talk about that.
Yeah, we can't talk about it.
No, definitely not.
Ben, I think the real advantage to this is merchandising.
Oh, definitely.
You're going to want toys.
Oh, speaking of, have you seen that they've started releasing the Warcraft movie toys?
No.
Yeah, they're out. I think they're at Toys R Us. There's a battle pack with, like, characters, and I guess you can get a Doomhammer.
Well, I mean, they're giving everybody else a Doomhammer, so why not?
True. True. I have one on my shaman in Legion.
See? Everybody gets a Doomhammer. Ben, if you want something other than a Doomhammer, you should check out /loot.com, home of the official Azeroth Roundtable t-shirt. It's a fantastic shirt featuring our logo and our Murloc with a mic. You just need to go to /loot.com, click on podcasts, and find the official Azeroth Roundtable t-shirt today.
Today. Or tomorrow.
Or any day.
Yeah, do it every day.
Buy a shirt a day. It'll be the same shirt, but, you know, you'll have backups.
Yeah, backups are good, especially when it comes to shirts, because you can spill.
Backups are important, Ben. Let me tell you a little story here, a little side note.
Mm-hmm.
The other day, I was running a little bit late. I thought, man, this is going to be a problem for me. Do you know why I was running late, Ben?
Why were you running late?
I was running late because I couldn't find my keys.
Oh, dude. And you have such a tidy apartment, too.
It's the worst feeling in the world to be looking for your keys and not knowing where to find them. Now, thankfully, I had a backup key, and I was able to get out and make it to work on time. But let me tell you something, Ben, I could have avoided all that disaster if I had a flashy, easy to look at, nice, high quality keychain attached to those keys.
Well, I've got to ask, why don't you have one of those?
I don't have a good reason, because I just found out I can pick up the official Azeroth Roundtable keychain from geekasylum.etsy.com. I can add the kind of bling that I would need to find my keys in a dark room. Not too dark, but, you know, a reasonable level. I don't want to mislead anybody out there. You can also make a necklace out of it. A mighty fine necklace. It's a separate product, but, you know, it's kind of the same.
Yeah. And as Jay in the chat room says, it's easy to look at.
Yeah. So if you can't find your neck, oh, there it is. Keychain.
Ta-da.
Necklace.
If you can't find your neck?
You're going to be real upset one day if you can't find your neck, Ben.
Yeah, because then you're either wearing a turtleneck or you're just going to have a bad day.
How did this happen? Ben, let me tell you a good way to avoid wearing a turtleneck. Buy the official Azeroth Roundtable t-shirt from SlashLoot.com. It's not a turtleneck.
No. Who likes turtlenecks anyway?
George Lucas.
Do you know anyone other than George Lucas who actually wears them and likes them?
No.
Yeah, I just... Yeah, it's like someone's really weakly choking you.
You're gonna die eventually.
Yeah, if I get bored, maybe. So, John, thanks for joining me on this episode and talking about the next expansion.
Got weird.
Yeah, thanks for that. But how can people find you?
Well, if you want to hear more from me, there are all sorts of ways to do it. Your best bet to find out what's going on is to follow me on Twitter. I'm at John_Jagger. I will let you know where I'll be. But right now, if you want to catch more of me, I was on the Training Dummies yesterday talking up Heroes of the Storm. That was really good. We had a great time. I also do a little podcast called Core!
Core!
That is also about Heroes of the Storm. Because I like talking about Heroes of the Storm, as it turns out. You can catch me on the Experience Points show. That's a live stream show. That is from 12 to 3 Mountain Standard Time every Saturday. That's at twitch.tv/frogpantscott. And in addition to that, I will also be guesting on Stormcast on Monday.
Stormcast.
That's a Heroes of the Storm podcast as well.
Wait, do you play Heroes of the Storm?
Ben... I play Heroes of the Storm. It's an exciting time.
Yes, it is.
Corn. Ben, yes. I did not yell corn, chat room. Core.
Core!
I guess maybe I have to be a bit more clear about that. Core!
Core!
So, Ben.
Yes, John.
Of the clan Bumhoffer.
Yes.
Where can people find you?
Best place to follow me, or find me rather, is actually on Twitter. I'm at Ben the Mage. You can find out such wonderful things as when I'm recording this show, or maybe talking about random other things, like when I'm doing Battle Pets or Geektopia, which, by the way, Geektopia coming back this weekend. Super excited because we're going to be talking about The Force Awakens. As for this show, if you want to follow
Ben, I like The Force Awakens a lot.
Oh, so do I.
Sorry to interrupt, but I wanted to acknowledge that I liked it, and I was angrily typing at the chat room.
Yeah, I know. That's great.
But the return of Geektopia is exciting, and I like The Force Awakens.
Well, thanks. I appreciate that.
Sorry I keep interrupting you, Ben.
It's okay. I'm actually really curious to see what Alakaz and Lita have to say about it, because... I know that Alakaz is going to be happy and likes it, and we'll see what Lita says. But anyway, so that's coming back. This show, however, Azeroth RT on Twitter, if you want to tell us your wonderful ideas for the what did we say it's going to be? The Phantom Death Knights expansion for World of Warcraft?
Ben, it's probably best we don't ask for additional feedback on this particular one.
Okay.
If you want to tell us more about Gold Sings
and other things.
Oh, yeah, we were going to read that email.
Yeah. Do you have it pulled up?
No.
Well, let me see if I can pull that up really quick.
The show's still going, everybody. Don't go away yet.
Yeah. Well, let me just finish up really quick and say that you can email us at azerothroundtable@gmail.com. And, of course, you can find us on Stitcher, iTunes, TuneIn, Alpha Geek Radio, and AzerothRoundtable.com for all of our episodes. Bull T Fury, a resto druid from Gold Ring US, says, if you want to change spec with no artifact, progress, transfer, new spec, then there's no gold cost. I don't really know exactly what that means. I'm thinking that means if you want to change your spec without the progress transfer into the new spec and different artifact, there's no gold cost. If you want to change spec and transfer all your current artifact progress to the new spec, then there's a heavy gold cost. I can see that as a good gold sink. What do you think, John?
I can see that as good. Yeah, that seems fine.
Yeah. Okay, cool. That's it for that. Really quick. Cool. Thank you for that.
Our stream is going weird. Is it going weird for you? Or is it just me? No,
looks okay for me so far.
Oh, well, apparently mine's just for you. Probably because I keep changing the stupid animated GIF.
Yeah, possibly. Possibly. But anyways, Azeroth Roundtable, thank you very much for joining us, and have a good night, everybody.
Bye.
Okay, there we go. Yeah. Bye.
Well, I mean, we're still streaming. It's just thinking right now.
I know.
Okay.
Anyways, I'm gonna stop recording now. Sound good? You good with that, John?
I'm sorry, I was coughing.
Oh, okay.
I'm dying, Ben.
Need to come over and give you CPR?
I'm gonna cry on camera.
Do I need to give you mouth to mouth? Because I don't want to do that.
Bear. Hi, chat room.
We make weird noises before and after the show.
Yeah. This time it's being recorded. Yay.
Very true. So yeah, every now and then when I was looking over at the actual stream, and then all of a sudden the evil ducky gif popped up. Thanks for that. Did you ever play a bunch of Five Nights at Freddy's?
No, I played none. Me neither. I just like the animated GIF.
Hey, there it is. Very cool. What are the plans for experience points tomorrow?
I don't know. I would imagine Scott's going to maybe show off some of Tomb Raider, because I know he's way into that. We're going to do Heroes for the third hour. I don't know what else, though.
What's the second hour?
Ooh. Who knows? I don't even know about the first hour. So.
Ooh.
Will
I can see him doing Tomb Raider, though. Because, yeah, he's been tweeting a bunch about it today.
I want it so bad. Ben, I want...
Okay.
I just can't... XCOM 2 comes out next month.
So, I might do something bad, John.
What are you going to do?
Twilight Princess comes out in March.
Nope. Don't do it.
I enjoyed it back in the day.
Don't do it.
Why?
Ben, if I told you I was planning to cut off an arm, would you say, sure, John, give it a go. See if you like having only one arm.
Well, question.
Okay.
Are you going to be getting a replacement arm?
No.
Okay. Where are you cutting it off at?
The wrist.
Like on the arm. Not like, I don't know, at some dude's house.
It's just like there. Oh, you can't see it. Never mind.
No, I can't.
Well, shoot. I don't know. Like above the wrist. Slightly above the wrist.
Slightly above the wrist?
Ben, the point is it shouldn't freaking matter. Don't. By Twilight Princess.
Why? I enjoyed that game.
Yes.
And I like Zelda
the
games.
First time. You have no reason to play through it again. It's gonna look like utter shit at this point. And it's not gonna mean anything because you already know how it ends. You've already had the emotional connection to it. That was the only thing that game had going for it. And like one of the dungeons was cool.
Which one?
The sand one.
That one was pretty cool, wasn't it?
Yeah. One cool dungeon and a cool ending does not a game make. You're going to be fighting the stupid giant pig Ganon and looking at crappy possessed Zelda, and you're going to be like, oh, right, this one sucked butt. You should play Wind Waker again and play a good Zelda game and just be like, all right, I'm good. I don't need it anymore.
I should get Wind Waker, shouldn't I?
Yes, buy that one. Buy a good Zelda game.
I might do both.
Don't do... No! That is making your problem slightly worse.
I did get the Toon Link amiibo for Christmas. Someone gave it to me, John. I didn't buy it myself.
Okay. Well, shoot. I need to be friends with this person. I want a Toon Link amiibo.
Oh, Spaz, the N64 graphics. Okay, John, let's do N64 hands.
Okay, wait, hold on. I need to address something. N64 hands. I'll do N64 hands while I address Brewmaster Wansu. Brewmaster Wansu, buying Chrono Trigger anytime it comes out on every console ever is fine. It is a fantastic game. It is one of the best games ever made, period. Zelda Wind Waker is one of the shittier Zeldas of all time.
Wind Waker?
Or not Wind Waker, shoot.
Thank you.
Twilight Princess is one of the shittier Zeldas ever made.
I was about to walk over there and bust down your door.
It doesn't look good. It suffers from that problem of, like, it looked good at the time, and even at the time it didn't look great. So now with high-res textures, it's still going to look like crap. I haven't seen one screenshot of that high-def, quote-unquote high-def version that even looks remotely cool. Don't do it, Ben.
We'll see.
I can tell you're gonna do it. Don't do it. Buy the amiibo or something. I would actually rather you just get the amiibo than buy the game again.
The amiibo does look pretty cool. Because I like wolves.
There you go. Buy the amiibo. Don't buy the game. It's not good. It's okay at best. Buy a good game. There's a lot of good games out there. Buy a good game.
I know, I'm working on that part.
It's weird that you keep just buying old games you've already played.
I like those games. There's but I have
games
got, I have
you might
games,
like
John.
Out there that are new that you haven't
I've
already played.
New games. I bought Sona or Soma. Hmm? And I know you probably think it's stupid, but Disney Infinity 3.0 is pretty kick ass. Some of the best Star Wars games I've played. Put it this way, John. We have different gaming tastes at times. A lot of the time.
Mm-mm. That's the problem. The problem is you like a lot of crap, but you also tend to enjoy good games. But you keep investing in the crap. Or sometimes the occasionally good games that you've already bought. There's good games out there, Ben. Get a good game.
Yeah, Brewmaster Wansu. Woo! See?
Hold on, what did he say?
The Twilight of the Republic is great. Ahsoka Tano, worth the whole thing.
Ahsoka Tano is great.
She's pretty cool.
Sure, you know what? I'm fine with you owning Disney Infinity. Don't buy Twilight Princess. That's the one that bugs me. When I say this game's really cool...
You might have actually convinced me, John.
When I say this game's really cool, you would like it. The reason you always say no is because you can't afford it. So why would you spend money on a game you've already played that's going to have diminishing returns on your life now at this point, and then gives you the opportunity... It doesn't even have to be one I recommend. It can be one that you go to on your own. Just new. Just new.
You might have convinced me.
Good.
The fact that it didn't pre-order it already on Amazon means that I was already in a...
That said, I can't wait to play some Pokemon Red.
I'm not playing any more.
I'm kidding.
Wait, is there a new one coming out?
No, it's a port of the original.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Oh.
I'm going to probably get it.
Hey, don't play that. How far did you get in the newest one?
Which newest one?
That's right. There were two new X and Ys.
Well, there was Black and White, and then they did Ruby and Sapphire.
Look, that's the point, John. It's the same game every single time.
It's an amazing game every single time.
No, it's not.
It's fun for me.
No.
Ben?
Just because it's fun for you doesn't mean it's a good game.
Guess what?
What?
They're going to be giving away Mew.
Are they doing Yellow? Because I played Yellow.
Yes, Yellow is out as well. Digital version of Yellow.
You get Mew? Dang it, you said the one thing that I care about.
A freaking Mew is always the one.
And all it is just the same thing as the very original.
Hold on, let me see when Mew is available. They talked about it. Pokemon 20th. Did you see the trailer for Detective Pikachu?
No.
Oh my gosh, Ben. Okay, hold on. There's stuff we need to deal with here. Okay, first let me find out when you can get Mew.
Why am I even learning this?
Because it's exciting news.
No, it's not.
Get mythical Pokemon. February. Mew. But you only can get him if you have Pokemon X, Pokemon Y, Pokemon Alpha Sapphire, or Pokemon Omega Red.
Oh, I do have Pokemon X or Y.
So you'll just do... Remember how you got the Torchic?
Yeah.
That's how you'll get Mew.
Well, how do I get it?
You just log in and you do your special gift in February, and then you get Mew. And then you'll have a Mew for the whole thing.
So what you're saying is I need to buy a couple extra, like, Pokemon games? So that I can get a Mew on each of them and then give them to myself and then just have a full team of six Mews.
That's all you need. Statistically proven, you just need Mew. He's the only Pokemon you need. So, okay, so you get Mew then. What was the other thing?
Just when in February? Just any time in February?
I think any time in February.
You need to remind me.
Okay.
Because that's important business.
They're going to do it with all the legendaries, but I know, like me, you only care about Mew.
Yeah, that's all
he's
care
the
about.
Only one that mattered. Oh, wait. I think this is the trailer that has Danny DeVito doing the voice of Detective Pikachu.
Oh, my God.
That might be
We're
better.
Evolving. Your mother
well, first off,
is
I'm
going to
go ahead and cut off Alpha Geek. Alpha Geek, you've been great. Thank you very much.
I didn't
much.
Go to Vietnam.
Have a wonderful night, everybody.
Just to have pansies like you take my freedom away from me.
My roommate was a frog kid.
Totally
you ever see a
out.
Frog kid?
Okay, Ben, I'm going to share with you the Danny DeVito version. I want you to know this, okay? In the real trailer, the non-Danny DeVito trailer, it's all in Japanese, so it's not like it matters too much because you're not going to understand it either way.
Okay.
But he does have a deep voice. Danny DeVito, yes, it is not an unreasonable assumption that Danny DeVito would voice him.
That makes no sense.
He has a deep voice.
Pikachu.
I put it in the chat so that the chat could enjoy it as well.
Okay, are we going to do the whole countdown play it at the same time thing?
No, you can just play it.
Okay, oh, the webpage is not available.
What?
Oh, there it is.
There we go.
We're evolving. Your mother is dead.
Who wants rum ham?
I didn't go to Vietnam just to have pansies like you take my freedom away from me.
My roommate was a frog kid. You ever see a frog kid? Those guys got bashed and bloody. I need some trash to plug up the cut. Humans are filthy.
It's the hat. It's the hat that does it.
The hat's pretty great,
this.
Right?
I just... can't believe it! I am not a human being! I am an animal! Cold-blooded! Look, if life pushes you down, you gotta push back. If you're dealt a bunch of lemons, you gotta take those lemons and stuff them down somebody's throat until they see yellow. Detective
Pikachu!
This is amazing.
I don't know how many years on this earth I got left. I'm gonna get real weird with it.
Detective. I'm tired of people telling me what I can't do. I'll say I can't be a pilot. I can't be a doctor.
He's got a little detective hat.
I might need to play that game. So stupid. Oh my gosh.
He speaks English and he's got a deep voice. It's great.
Oh, okay. Well, I need to go because I need to eat and then go to bed because I'm working tomorrow.
You know what? I have to get up early tomorrow too. You know what I need to get up early for?
Mm-hmm. Core!
Mm-mm.
I know it's not core. I just want to say.
You know what I need to get up early for, Ben?
What do you need to get up early for?
I need to get up early for breakfast.
Ooh. What you doing for breakfast?
Going to the Black Bear Diner, ordering the Grizz.
Gotcha.
The Grizz, Ben.
The Grizz.
The Grizz.
The Grizz.
All right, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yes,
and
thank
putting
you.
Up with our nonsense tonight. You all take it easy and have a good one.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.